it's a lovely autumn afternoon here on the northern tablelands in the New England, and it's beautiful up here. It's one of the reasons, you know, it's a huge reason why I like living up here, and it's a great place to live. Cool climate, you have to like cool climate, and then occasional snow where we live. It's a great place to ride motorcycles, providing you don't mind a bit of cool weather. And that's the highway over there, the New England Highway, and we're about just a couple of k's south of Glencoe, which is on the way to Glen Innes, north of Armidale. And we're test riding the old girl again this afternoon, trying to work out what we think about it. It feels a bit underpowered. I just think it's not lacking horsepower, it's lacking the delivery of said horsepower. I think gonna have to, you know, my mate Mark's coming to visit tomorrow. He's got a timing light, so we'll get the timing light out and just check the timing, you know, check points gap, that kind of stuff, just to make sure it's running as well as it is. Sometimes it feels like it's just running on about 1.5 to 1.75 cylinders kind of thing, instead of the full 2. It's fun to ride. It's a good bike to ride. You know, it's just that Harley thing where you've got modest but torquey power delivery. It's no Rocket 3, but, you know, you wouldn't want it to be a Rocket 3. We've got a Rocket 3. And this is my brother's bike, and as said, we'll always be honoured to ride it. And she's a lovely old girl. And I'm sure Tim would like being here right now on his Road King, probably, or his Trident, or, you know, any of his other bikes. He'd be complaining. He'd be saying, oh, it's a bit cold, because, you know, he's a Queenslander and a Western Australian. He lived up in Kununurra for more than 20 years. Then he was in Mackay, then in Brisbane, so he doesn't like the cold weather. You know. Whereas I'm a bit the opposite. I don't mind a bit of cool weather, providing I don't actually feel cold myself. Yeah. I'm just wondering, couldn't remember that I'd turn that on or off. Yeah, cold weather's alright, as long as you feel warm. That's what it's about, isn't it? We'll ride this old girl home now. It won't be long before we're putting the summer gloves away for the year and getting out the warmer ones. And this bike, of course, has got no mods and cons like heated grips or whatnot. Although I could put some on it. Just get some Oxford ones. I'm going to ride it a bit more frequently in the winter. I might well do that. 4Ks to Glen.
thing I wanted to say is the way Tim set up these bars and stuff really well for me. They suit the sidecar and my riding position very nicely. So that's Tim, you know, he knew what to do. another train of thought is that I'm probably not riding it right. I'm so used to the Rocket 3, which is a different kind of power delivery. Maybe I might be changing into top gear just too early. You know, you change up the top and then it sort of loses revs. I'll have to think about all that. Well, we'll take it home now, and tomorrow we'll have a look at it, put the timing light on it. Put the timing light on the old girl, check the points, gap, that kind of stuff. Put some new plugs in her, have a look at the carb, that sort of stuff, and see how that goes. If that doesn't make any difference, well, we'll just get used to riding it along and pottering along and enjoying ourselves. And looks like we've scared the cattle away. There's a surprise. Smells like a motorbike. Idles well, which is good. Didn't expect it to.
stop, don't we? Home again, and thanks Uncle Tim, that's a good ride. Nice afternoon, beautiful day, and we'll sort this girl out, I reckon. You know, have a look at that, the stuff that I've been talking about. It seemed to go along quite nicely then, you know. It won't be as big a drama as I thought it would be once you get it out on the, you know, at speed, at distance. It'll sit on probably 110, and that's all I need anyway. So it's just lacking a little bit, you know, going up hills and stuff at the moment. But as I said, it could be me just not getting her on the cam properly. You change up in the top of a bit over 100, then it'll stay up there fairly nicely. So we'll keep riding it, and we'll work it out. Now, one more thing before we put the bike to bed for the evening is getting a couple of rides in on this bike, and I'm starting to feel more human again myself, because it's been a while. The trunk's been playing up for a while, so it's nice to just get back out there on the road and get the wind in your, I was gonna say hair, but I've got bugger all hair really, so wind bugs in your teeth, that kind of stuff, you know what it's like.